So usually my trading setup consists of a laptop, a gaming laptop that has two external monitors, and I use those two external monitors to hold my different charts and whatnot, right? Now that works great while I'm trading at home, but sometimes, you know, I need to go places, I need to travel for whatever reason, like I had to do a few weeks ago, right? So of course, when I'm traveling, I'm not going to be able to take, I could, but that's just going to be too much trying to take my laptop and my two monitors, or, you know, trying to take a laptop and two monitors. So I have a more convenient setup when I travel, which is basically just trading off my MacBook. Now for my system, all I need is the one monitor to trade off of. I use two monitors at home for just to, you know, have extra stuff up, but I only really look at one monitor. So I only need one monitor for the way that I trade. So when I travel, instead of taking the laptop that I normally trade off of, I take my MacBook Pro. And the way that I'm able to do that is by using Parallels. Now there are other options, but Parallels is the one that I prefer. And that's the one that I'm gonna talk about in this video for how I trade while I travel. So if you're not using Parallels already, there will be a link, an affiliate link in the description below that you can take advantage of if you want to get started with Parallels. But I use Parallels to trade while I'm not at home. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to open up Parallels and I'm going to let you see how it loads up and the time it takes and all that stuff. So let me just get right into it. Let me just go to Parallels, go to my applications here, scroll down to Parallels desktop. And you can see I just paused it. I'll talk about that a little bit more later on in this video. And what I'm going to do, now I'm controlling this from my MacBook using TeamViewer. I'm actually on my MacBook right now and I'm just using TeamViewer so I can record it for this video. All right, so that's all the explaining that we're going to do on that side of the game. And if you want more details about Parallels, I did make another video. This is a full review for Parallels, but I'll link that video also in the description and all of that good stuff. All right, so I want to show, you can see, like, I'm not really having any issues running Parallels on my MacBook. Everything's working pretty good. Just had one time where I just need to click inside of Parallels so I can close down Sierra chart, but no issue so far. So I'm showing all this to show that there's not a ton of lag or anything like that. Even, you know, turning on Parallels and opening up windows, I haven't really had any issues with doing that, which makes trading possible on Parallels. And Sierra Chart, unfortunately, they haven't made a version for MacBook yet. So getting this set up, I wanted to kind of mirror my normal layout as much as possible. But this is pretty much what I came up with. If you do experience any lag whatsoever, most of the lag is going to be on opening it up for the first time. And then after you open it up for the first time, it's kind of, it depends on, you know, what kind of system you're using. That could be kind of typical for a Sierra chart. Just that initial loading everything, it can be a little slow in the beginning, but once everything is loaded in and you get all your data and all that stuff, then you won't have any other more issues with Sierra chart. And that works the same with Parallels. All right, historical data is complete. I like to let everything catch up. Like I say, starting it up for the first time, there may be a little bit of lag. But once Sierra chart gets caught up, then you're good to go. So this is the setup that I basically had while I was traveling, right? And to really show how this worked in real time, because like right now the market isn't, this is a holiday, so the market has actually closed at this point. It had an early close today, so we're not going to be able to see a whole lot today for like testing purposes to really see how it works. But what I want to do here is show the recording that I had from that day where I was actually trading. And I was doing all this for the first time. Like I don't travel too often, but I was testing it for this just to see how it would work. And I wasn't completely focused, you know, while I was traveling. So I did all this in sim mode just to make sure that, you know, everything was cool. And plus I wasn't as focused as I should have been. So let me go ahead and play this. And to keep in mind, I was also doing this while I like to screen record my trading sessions. So I was using OBS to screen record my trading session, also on the MacBook Pro. And I had some other things going in the background. This is muted, so you're not going to be able to hear anything, but I had some other stuff playing in the background. So there was a lot of processes running at the same time on my MacBook Pro while I have parallels running and while I'm trading in a live, a regular day in a live market. You can see I was messing with a couple of my settings. Actually, I think I still needed to set some things up. That's what it looks like I'm doing here. So you can see I placed a test trade there. Make sure everything was working. Didn't have any experience, any lag or anything like that. But while I did have other processes running, you also, just to make sure that you're not just unnecessarily using resources, you do want to close down any unnecessary windows. So normally on my MacBook, I have a lot of browser windows and tabs open. I closed all of that down to, just to make sure everything was operating efficiently, so that the only thing that was open, I had Discord open, I had Notion open, and then I had the OBS for screen recording, and then Parallels and Sierra Chart. Those are the only things that I had open, the things that were necessary for trading. And that's how you'll get the most uses, the most efficiency out of the resources on your MacBook, on your laptop, right? With Parallels. Like I say, Parallels runs on top of the Mac OS. So it's really efficient, and it does depend on how outdated your MacBook is. I know I had one that was from 2010. This is a couple years ago, and the resources on that, everything was outdated, right? It was an outdated MacBook, but I was able to run Parallels with no issues and still trade from it and do all that stuff on an old, outdated MacBook Pro, right? So this MacBook Pro here it's a little bit more updated. I think this is a 2020 version with the M1 chip. And as you can see, I have absolutely no issues trying to trade and do everything within Sierra charts while I trade in the parallel. So that's basically really what I wanted to make this video for, to show how I would go about trading in Sierra chart while I'm traveling, or while I'm, if I'm not at my regular trade station, right? And if I'm not at my regular desk. Now, some things that you can think that you would have to consider is, like, the settings that you have for Sierra chart on your primary system, like all of your chart windows, all of your trade window configs, all of your indicators, all your, however you have it set up, you're going to want to make sure that you copy that over to your whatever mobile device that you're using. In this instance, a MacBook Pro. So I had to take all of those settings and I had to copy those over to the MacBook Pro and save them within the right folder inside of Parallels. So let me go back to Parallels. If I go into my Parallels folder, and then I have to find where I have Sierra chart, I conveniently pinned it over here. So I use Google Drive, I believe, right? I either use Google Drive or use iCloud to save those files over, and it's mostly going to be files that you're going to put in the data. You don't necessarily need to worry about your data files, but you'll want to make sure, like, these your chart settings and your trade window settings and all of that stuff, you want to make sure that's copied over. So you want to make sure that the Sierra chart version that you're using on your MacBook Pro matches the Sierra chart version that you've been using on your normal setup, right? So that all the studies work the way that they're supposed to, and you don't run into any technical issues with anything that you're using, right? And when you're done for the day, I found the most efficient thing to do is just to go up in here. This is Parallels. It says Windows 11. I'm running Windows 11 here. My normal trade setup, I run it on Windows 10, but for Parallels, I wanted to test it out too for Windows 11. So I'm running Windows 11 again, no issues like you can see. But when I was done for the day, I just, instead of shutting everything down, all I do is I either pause it or I suspend it. So if it's early in the week, I just pause it. And like I'm going to trade tomorrow, I just pause it so that when I open it back up, there's not a whole lot that it needs to do to catch back up. Like trying to open up, the different software and all that stuff you're doing again. it'll just open back up and then it'll catch up. Sierra chart will catch up from wherever you left off, right? Or if you really want to shut things down, like let's say you're done for the weekend, or you're just done for the week, you can suspend it or you can shut it down. You can do whatever you want to. Like if I'm shutting it down for a longer period, I'll suspend it, right? And then I could just go ahead and close it all the way down and it'll be ready for the next time. It'll pick up from there the next time I'm ready to use it, right? So, you know, I just wanted to cover that as a couple of things that I learned from my experience trying to trade in Sierra Chart while I'm traveling. And if you have any questions, just leave those in the comment section below. And until the next time, trade it easy.